Hi, my name is Linda Pugliese and I am a physiotherapist at Toronto Rehab. The goal of this video is to offer tips and ideas for healthcare providers who want to assess their patients' balance and mobility using Telerehab. This video is geared more towards a population who have impairments in balance and mobility and are seeking rehab as part of their recovery. We first need to help our patients get ready for Telerehab. We know that the more prepared they are, the more valuable and safe their Telerehab will be. We have developed a number of resources to help patients and caregivers get Telerehab ready. One of our videos is devoted entirely to patient safety, and another helps patients prepare for a virtual therapy session. It is also important to prepare your clinical space. The ideal Telerehab setting has adequate space to demonstrate a wide variety of activities across various planes of movement and surfaces. Ensure you have everything you need for the session within reach. I try to use a space that replicates my patient's home environment. For example, if I am assessing bed mobility, I have a floor mat or a plinth available. If I am working on standing balance, I may set up in a corner or with a chair beside me. Another important step is knowing as much as you can about your patient before you meet them. Reviewing their past history will help you better understand their abilities and goals. Be sure to identify any cognitive, communication, hearing, or visual impairments that will be important to consider as part of your session. There are many things about our patient's physical status that we observe when meeting them in person, but that are less obvious in the virtual environment. I devote quite a lot of time to first understanding my patient's balance and mobility before asking them to move. Hi, Shruti. Great to meet you.
Hi, Linda. It's nice to finally meet you.
I see you've got your dining room all set up with your assessment today. You have a sturdy chair and the table beside you, ready if you need it for balance. So it looks like your space is clear of all obstacles and you're wearing your running shoes. I can see and hear you. Can you see and hear me okay?
I sure can.
And do you have a cell phone within reach in case of emergency?
I do.
Great. So before we get moving, I would like to ask you a few questions about your mobility. Can you tell me how you are moving in your house?
In my house, I am mostly on my feet using a walking stick, and I have a device. I have an air cast on.
And what about outdoors?
And outdoors, I use my wheelchair as a sort of mode of transportation. And I've just started to walk a little bit on my balcony, short walks.
Okay, have you had any falls or near falls in the past 6 months?
No, I have not. I'm still a bit unsteady walking outdoors.
Shruti, do you think you could have a family member take a video of you outdoors so I can have a better look?
Absolutely, I will do that this afternoon and I will email it to you for our next session.
Great. Let's shift now to some ideas for objective assessments for balance and mobility, starting with a few tips. Be sure to use concise communication and demonstrate the activity to ensure that your patient clearly understands what you're asking them to do before they try it. Shruti, I'd like to see if you can stand without holding on for support. Watch me demonstrate first, and then I will ask you to do it. Make sure there is equal weight through your feet. Use the arm of the chair if you have to, and the table is there for your support if you need it to. Okay, do you feel comfortable to try?
Yeah, I'm ready. Thanks.
Okay. That was great. Another way to help both you and your patients feel safer is to use a graded approach to balance. This involves taking your patient through less challenging to progressively more challenging tasks. For example, start in sitting before transitioning into standing activities. Start with an arm in support before you move to no support. Shruti, I would like to assess your balance when you're not holding on. When you're ready, lift your right hand off the table, but I want you to keep it close so that you can hold on if you need to.
All right, sounds good.
Another example is to start with more static balance activities with the feet stable before trying more dynamic movements. A progression could start with simple weight shifting, then progress to balance while moving, for example, stepping forwards or sideways. For activities that are even more challenging, such as one-legged or tandem stance, you may want to set up in a corner with walls on both sides for support. As an aside, if you can, choose a laptop or computer with a camera that can move around, similar to how you would in person. This will allow you to zoom in on specific aspects of a task to ensure your patient can clearly see and understand. Let's move now from standing with your feet apart, which you're doing so well, to something more challenging, like placing your feet close together. I will move my camera so you can have a better look at my feet.
Yeah, sure thing.
That looks great, Shruti. That's great. It can sometimes be difficult to gauge how challenging activities can be when viewing your patient over a screen. Consider using a rating of perceived exertion scale, which asks people to rate their overall sense of effort. Shruti, you have been doing activities for about 20 minutes now. Looking at your screen, on a scale of 0 to 10, what number would best describe how hard your body is working, your overall sense of exertion?
I'm feeling okay. I'd probably be about between a 2 and a 3.
We hope that this has been helpful in offering ideas on how to perform balance and mobility assessments and interventions in a telerehab setting. Do you have any other ideas? We'd love to hear them. Send us an email at trivirtualrehab@uhn.ca.